Good afternoon. This is Pastor David Michael Washington from Kingdom Worship 7, along with Prophetess Nicole C. Washington. Hey, God got a word for you and you and for me. Repeat after me. When the day of Pentecost arrived. Can y'all say it again? When the day of Pentecost arrived. See, God got a word for you this morning through the word of God that he put it in me to give to you. So I want y'all to follow me into the sanctuary because God's going to speak to us and blow our mind with the word of God. Are y'all ready? Come on, let's go. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Oh, I just want to give God the honor and the praise for allowing me to wake up this morning and to see a brand new day. You know, I also thank God for the storms that came in my life and that are in my life because God is giving me the strength and the power to overcome those storms. Listen, I didn't ask for the storm, but one thing I do realize and understand is when your mama and your daddy or your grandparents tried to tell you something when you was a young woman or a young man and you didn't want to listen or you did wrong to somebody, and what they would say to you is you'll reap what you sow. You may not reap it in your younger years, but believe me, Lord have mercy, you're going to reap what you sow in your latter years. Good God Almighty. But I thank God for my reaping, because my reaping let me realize and understand you better get it together. You better believe that God is the only one can bring you out of your mess. And also, when you reap, listen, when you go through, you're going to teach the next generation what not to do so they don't have to reap. That's not my message for today. But I also give honor and praise to a prophetess, Nicole C. Washington, who is a prayer warrior. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. She's also, listen to this one, she's also a demon bully. Oh, y'all don't know what I'm talking about. She is what you call a demon bully, meaning she can't stand bullies. She can't stand how these demons go around bullying people in the spirit. So what she do, she said, I'm not scared of you bully. I ain't scared of you demon. Because the man I serve up in the heaven, he has given me the power to cast out demons like you. Lord have mercy. I thank God for her. And I thank God for the things that she does for the ministry. That's Kingdom Worship 7 Church of God in Christ. So I give God the honor and the praise for her. Well, we're going to get into this word. We're not going to be here before you long. God has given me a word to give to you this morning. Well, this is a special time. I thought maybe I would put on my sparkling jacket this morning because we are going to meet somebody. We're going to meet something this morning that we all need in our life. And I feel when we meet this awesome spirit, listen, we need to look our best. And sometimes you cannot look your best, but you must have your mind in position to receive what's getting ready to come your way. Now, on this Sunday, listen, all across the world, listen, there are so many spiritual leaders and organization are recognizing and giving honor to the Holy Spirit that is in their midst. Amen. Now, we remember that the Pentecostal, listen to this. Now, the day of Pentecostal is the day that all believers are proclaiming the good news God has made Jesus, listen, the one who was crucified, both Lord and Christ. Now, what I'm saying is because Jesus came down here, and let me back up. When God told his son, listen, Jesus, I got a test for you to do. I got a job for you to do. I need for you to go down to that earth down there, and I need for you to do something. I believe that Jesus did not talk back to his daddy, but Jesus stood there paying attention. And when his dad told him, see, son, I need for you to go down to the earth. As bad as those knuckleheads get on my nerve down there on earth, I still have an unconditional love for them. And I want to show them how much I love them. So, Jesus, I need for you to go down there and live among them. Oh, my God. But when you go down and live among them, I want you to learn about them. And then when the time comes for you to have to be ascended back in heaven to come back home, listen, I want you just to understand I'm doing this because I love them. For the Bible said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. I believe that's all I need to say right there. But we need to understand that we as believers, when we're proclaiming about the Holy Spirit, first of all, that Holy Spirit, listen, the Holy Spirit is not something that's going to cause you to run across the church and shout and fall over the floor and jump over the pew. No, that is not the Holy Spirit. Oh, now lesson, we're going to talk about what is the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is a gentleman, amen. Oh, y'all, I got to cool down. Let me bring it down, because I want to teach this word this morning. Amen, amen. But we are going to get into our lesson. And like I always say every Sunday, maybe you need to get your pen, your pencil, with an eraser, piece of paper, get your devices, take notes, because I'm going to give you some pointers. I'm going to give you some good things you may want to write down to apply to your life. Amen. Now, if you get your Bible, let's turn to Acts, the second chapter, starting at the first verse. Everybody got it? I'm going to wait 10 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 seconds is up. All right. The word reads like this. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. Do y'all mind if I read that again? And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. Oh my God. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. Oh, number three. And there appeared to them a cloven tongue like as a fire, and it sat upon each of them. All right. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. Can I say that again? And they were all filled. They were all filled, not half filled, not just a little, but they were all filled, good God Almighty, with the Holy Ghost, and began to speak with their tongue as the Spirit gave them utterance. Amen. And they were dwelling at Jerusalem. They were dwelling in Jerusalem. Listen, oh my God. And devout men out of every nation under heaven. And verse 6 and the final. Now when this day, this noise abroad, the multitudes came together and were confounded. Amen. Oh my God. Because that every man heard them speak in his own language. Amen. Oh, we just thank God for what we just read. And the Bible says, and when the day of Pentecost. Now, we want to look at this. We want to do a little history first. I am a history teacher. I taught public school. And one thing I do, I love history. History gives us a background on why things are the way they are now, and where there was a beginning, there was a middle, and there is an end. And here it says in Acts the second chapter, it set the time of the Jewish Pentecostal holiday known as the Feast of the Week. Now, this holiday occurred 50 days after Passover within Judaism. In ancient Judaism, it was a holiday celebrating the wheat harvest. Now, you can find that in Jeremiah. Listen, I'm going to give you a little scripture. You can find that in Jeremiah 5 and 24, Deuteronomy 16, 9 through 11, and Isaiah 9 and 2. It was a time when the first fruit of the harvest was presented to God in the temple. And the Israelites celebrated with a meal, amen, and also with festivity or with celebration. So by the time Jesus and disciple in the first century, when Jesus came in on his time, it said the Jews from all over the world, listen, living from one side to another side, from all over, they gathered, they came to Jesus, especially the disciple. See, when the Bible said that in the Old Testament, when it was the celebration to celebrate their first fruit, here is again Pentecost. The first fruit, who was that? That was Jesus. And a celebration is when all the people came together to celebrate. But at this time, oh my God, at this time, the disciples also came. But we got to understand, in the midst of the celebration, something glorious was getting ready to happen. Amen. Have you ever went to a party and you see your friends just dancing and doing what they do, you know, doing the twerk, you know, some of these new dancers they got out, and everybody just enjoying themselves. But then there's something else going on in another room, and it seems like all the attention that was on the room with the dancing, all of a sudden, the attention went to that room where something glorious was going on. And that's how it was here in our lesson. There was a festival going on, or entertainment going on out there, festivity. But then there was something special going on. Ooh, good God, my. Because the Bible says, listen to this. It says here, it says, and when the day of Pentecost was fully came, or come, they were all with one accord. See, on that special day, look, you had a group of disciples. They all met in the upper room, not in the lower room or the side room, but the Bible said they met in the upper room. Now, we want to dissect something here. We want to dissect in verse 2. It said, and suddenly came a sound from heaven as a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where there was sitting. Now, one thing in point one, first, we want to realize in Acts 2 and 2, it says, first, there was a sound like a violent wind. Amen. When it said it was rushing, anything that rushes, it moves quickly. It moves with swiftness. It moves so fast. And the Bible says here that it came suddenly out of nowhere. It's like a hurricane. It just came out of nowhere. The newsman could not detect it. They could not locate it on the map, but because suddenly it just appeared. And here that it suddenly appeared like a violent wind. Now, Luke described this as a fiery tongue on each person as a sign of God's presence. Meaning when it came in, listen, and it began to go onto each person, it was described by Luke saying that was the presence of God. Oh my God. So when you see somebody in church sitting there and out of the blue, they begin to speak in tongue or begin to give God praise, that was nothing but the mighty rushing wind that settled on their spirit. And they begin to give God praise because they begin to think about all the good things God has done for them. Amen. And it says, in that moment, God is present among God's people. in the form of the Holy Spirit. So we got to understand this. For many centuries, people have been fighting over the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. But I'm here to tell you, they all are in the one. Amen. They all are in the triune. They all are in the triangle. They are all in the three, the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. But the Bible said, it says right here, that when the wind came in like a mighty rushing wind, that was the Holy Spirit. Remember when Jesus said, when I leave here and go back to my Father, there is someone or something going to come back in my place. Amen. And when it comes down, be ready to receive it. Oh my God. Woo! And point two, second. Listen to this. There are the sound of many tongues of language spoke inside the community of believer. Oh my God. When this mighty rushing wind came in, it came in for a reason. It didn't come in there to tear up or destroy or to demolish. It came in there to build things up. It came in there to build people up. It came in there to make changes. Oh, Lord, have mercy. Woo, Jesus. And our third point is that the third sound is outside of the community of believer. Sound like this brings different people together. See, the second sound was a sound with those people that was in the same room. It was dealing with them. So everybody in that room became on one accord. They begin to think alike, do things alike, speak so they can understand. See, when they say on one accord, there is nobody got their own agenda. There's only one type of agenda, and that's the agenda of the Holy Spirit. The Bible says when they all was in that room, listen, the Holy Spirit began to leap and jump on all of them within the room. So I'm inviting you this afternoon, if you want to get caught up in the Holy Spirit, get in the room, come in the room, get in the circle, come where God is showing you things, come where God is manifesting himself, come where God is giving blessing, come where God is letting you know that he is God. But here, like I said in our third point, the sound travel outside the wall. Good God Almighty, the mighty rushing wind was so powerful, it made more noise than the noise of today when the wind is sounding. It said that this wind was so strong that it went outside to the community of believers. It sounds like it was bringing different people in. It was letting people know that, listen, this mighty rushing wind was more than just about just coming in. It was coming in to change. Oh, my God. And the Bible said it began to speak in unknown tongues. Oh, can you explain that to me, Pastor? Yes, I'm glad you asked. I think I will. See, when the Bible said they begin to speak in unknown tongues, listen, let's get a little clarification on what's going on right here. See, when it came in, I'm telling you what the word said. I ain't telling you what I heard, but I'm reading it from my word. It said that when the mighty rushing wind came in, and it began to get on every man in there, and it said, and there appeared to them cloven tongues like as a fire, and it set upon each of them. And listen to that. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. And there was dwelling at Jerusalem, listen, and verse 6, listen to this. Now, when this was noise abroad, the multitude came together. Now, what I'm saying to you is when this tongue came in, when the Holy Spirit came in, everybody that was in there began to speak in unknown tongues. What you mean by that, Pastor? Well, they begin to speak in other languages. Amen. So if I was Spanish, oh my God, and I was Spanish, but I began to speak French, for some reason, my French, and I've never spoken it in my life, but my partner or my friend or a stranger over there began to understand what I was saying. Like, hold up, I thought you were Spanish, but you speaking my language. See, that's how the Holy Spirit do. The Holy Spirit would open up your spiritual ears to let you hear the sound what God wants you to hear. And it said that they begin to speak an unknown tongue so you can interpretate and hear other languages. Hey, like I said, yes, we know that there is another language that's directly to God, but right here, we are looking how the Holy Spirit, how the Holy Spirit is working, how it's making so that every man can understand the language of any other man. Oh my God. Oh my God. Woo, y'all, if y'all want this real Holy Spirit, if you really want to get connected to speaking in tongues, you gotta let the true Holy Ghost dwell in you. Amen. You gotta let it come and settle in your temple. Amen. Oh my God. See, we make sounds in our neighborhood when people are mistreated. See, when the Holy Spirit came in there, oh my God, it began to make sound. And because of that sound, there was a sound that the people in there began to make. See, it reminds me is when we make sound in our neighborhood, we make sound because somebody is being mistreated or ignored or somebody got killed. When we make sound, we are attacked or we are denied our basic rights or we are being treated wrongly. When we make sound, it's because we are being hurt by somebody because we are powerless. See, but when you make a sound, with the Holy Ghost, listen, that sound you can make is a sound of victory because you have overcome your situation. Why? Because the Holy Spirit has dwelt inside of you. Good God of mine. Ooh, Jesus. Oh, you know that God is good. You know that God is awesome. I dare you to give Here's some praise right now. I dare you to clap your hand, stomp your feet. Oh, I dare you just begin to magnify his name. Let me tell you how the Holy Spirit is. Listen to this. It can be quiet in the room. It can be like this. Quiet, nobody in the room. But because nobody is in the room, and you can't see them. But then you begin to hear the sound of the Holy Ghost. The sound of the wind. That is the Holy Ghost coming in. Getting ready to make change. Do the Holy Ghost make noise? Yes, it does. And when it makes noise, it gets your attention. This noise is more powerful than any weather sound. This noise is more powerful than the sound, the super sound of sound. This sound is even more loud than the woman that can hit the highest soprano note. This sound is so loud that it's louder than thunder. But when the Holy Spirit comes on in, good God of man, when the Holy Spirit comes on in, and you standing in the midst, wherever you are standing, it begin to make you act, like you know what you're feeling, what you're talking about. It make you want to get lined up in the Word of God. The Holy Spirit will make you do right, live right, talk right. It will even make you love right. Some of you cannot love your enemy because the Holy Spirit don't dwell inside of you. Some of you can't even love your spouse because the Holy Spirit is not inside of you. Some of you can't even live right because the Holy Spirit don't dwell inside of you. Oh my God. Now, I know you can put on your nice suit and go to church every Sunday with your big hat on, your fancy suit on, and you're sitting in your favorite pew. And when you go in there, you know, people look at you and say, oh, they look like they saved, they sanctified, and they filled with the Holy Ghost. But do you know how the Holy Ghost looks? Oh, we always want to dress up the Holy Ghost. But I believe that the Holy Ghost can dwell in a homeless man who has been humble to God all his life. I believe that the Holy Ghost can dwell in a person that nobody want to deal with or be friends with. I believe that the Holy Ghost can dwell in a person that is humble before God but don't have any friends. I believe that the Holy Ghost can dwell in a person that is just 100% sold out to God. Woo, my God. But we always want to dress up the Holy Ghost. We always want to put him on a pedestal. Oh, I know they saved and sanctified and got the Holy Ghost because look how they look. I'm sorry to tell you, the Holy Ghost can dwell in people you wouldn't even think got the Holy Ghost. Oh, so we need to stop being prejudiced. Stop picking and choosing who you want the Holy Ghost to be on. Oh my God. Because the God that I serve, God chooses anybody that he want to use to get his word across. The Holy Ghost that day went to the upper room and chose those that was in the upper room. And the Holy Ghost is even existing today. The Holy Ghost is here for you and here for me. The Holy Ghost, listen, it's sitting there. It's saying, choose you this day who you're going to serve. See, I want to dwell in your temple. Because if you allow me to dwell in you, you can get somewhere. But if you allow the devil to dwell in your temple, you will have a one-way ticket to hell. But if I dwell in you, oh my God, you will get to that place where there were many mansions prepared for you. So let me dwell in you. Oh my God. Woo! And when that day have arrived. Oh, when will your day arrive? What are you waiting on? Are you waiting for your friend to get saved? Are you waiting for your mama, your wife to get saved? God is saying this is an individual thing. You got to choose for yourself. The Holy Spirit is waiting. The Holy Spirit even calls your name. But it's up to you to answer. Oh, I hear Prophetess Nicole Washington many times talking to young women, telling them about the goodness of Jesus, telling them about their gifts, telling them about their anointing, telling them about the Holy Spirit. And sometimes I see the young girls, I look at their faces and see that they don't believe it. They don't want to receive it. They don't want none of that because they feel like the process of the Holy Spirit is too slow. But they feel like the process of the devil is just where they want to be. But baby girl, baby boy, I'm here to tell you today, you better choose the right spirit. Because that road of hard knocks, some of us can go down that road of hard knocks and return. And some of us can go down a road of hard knocks and end up in the grave. So you need to choose which way you want to go. Do you want to come with me to the day of Pentecost? Or do you want to go to the road what they call hell? The choice is yours. Oh my God. And I also go out to my adults. And I also talk to my church people. Those that have been saved 20, 30, 40 years, you ain't got it. You still making mistakes. You still trying to figure out who you are in the spirit. Some of you been playing with the Holy Spirit all your life. You ain't got the Holy Spirit, you got the Holy Spirit. God is saying he's tired of you playing. Get it right. God is saying if you can't get it right, prepare yourself for destruction. Prepare yourself for termination. Oh my God, I didn't mean to go there. But I just talking about the day of Pentecost. I hear it every year. And we just don't need to teach this time of year or when this day arrives. Some of us are teaching it every year, which is awesome. But we need to teach it even more. Because we know time is soon to come to an end. We see the time. We see the signs. We see things are going on. But the Bible clearly says, no man knows the days or the hour when the Son of Man shall what? Return. But all you need to do is pray without ceasing. Woo, I just thank God for this word. I thank God for the Holy Ghost. I thank God for the upper room and those that was in there. But most of all, I thank God for Jesus coming down to earth, taking the abuse that he took for our sins, for our iniquity. I thank God for his son Jesus dying on that cross to die for our sin. I also thank him for rising the third day. Ooh, and meeting the disciples and telling them to meet me. And oh my God, and he gave them instruction. I thank God for how Jesus ascended. But before he went up, he said there will be someone coming after me. Because that someone dwelled in my life. Even though I made mistakes along the way, I fell from glory, but I knew how to reach back for that Holy Ghost and say, I'm sorry, I repent. And because of that, the Holy Spirit said, you are forgiven. But did you forgive your fellow man? And I said, Holy Spirit, yes, I did. Then you are welcome in. Woo, my God. That is tight, but it's right. But I thank God for this word. And if there's anybody out there need prayer, anybody going to give their life to Christ, anybody that's dealing with a situation in their body, I am going to give you an email address that you can email us for prayer, for one-on-one, and it'll just be between you and that person. And the first email address, you will see it on our screen. There will be two email addresses that you can get in contact with. Send your prayer request, and we will get back with you as soon as possible. But I just thank God for this word, And next Sunday is Women's Day. Oh my God, we got a great speaker coming next Sunday, and that is prophetess Nicole C. Washington. And I already know she got a word, because third Sunday, she spoke on in the ninth month. Oh my God. And listen, y'all need to go back and look at that video. But she would be preaching next Sunday. And I want you guys to come back and enjoy a great word from her. And as we get ready to leave, I want you to just look at the announcements that we have and things that's going on in the kingdom. And man, God is doing some great things here. And if anybody needs to want to be a blessing to us, you will see our Cash App, if you would just like to bless the ministry so we can give back to the community and keep everybody in the world in prayer. This is your pastor, your friend, on behalf of myself and prophetess Nicole C. Washington. You guys have a great and awesome week. And remember, we love you, but God loves you greater. Peace out.